Hello guys, welcome back sa aking channel. Ako nga pala Sir Mar Santa Maria, Master Teacher 1 of Governor Luis A. Carrer Jr. East National High School na magbibigay sa inyo ng mga math techniques para mapadali ang topic niyo sa mathematics. Hi guys, at dahil sa ang laki na suporta niya sa aking channel, tatapusin na natin ngayon ang fourth quarter. So, quarter number 4, week number 8 about experimental and theoretical probability and word problems involving probability of simple events. Okay, so let us differentiate experimental and theoretical probability. So, in probability, an experiment is a process of repeating an activity whose outcomes are limited to a well-defined choice. So, say well-defined, ma-identify natin kung ano ba yung magiging outcomes natin. Halimbawa, in tossing a coin is either head or a tail. In rolling a dice, either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. Kaya tinawag siyang well-defined. The set of well-defined possible outcomes or choices in a statistical experiment is called the sample space. Kaya magiging sample space natin in tossing a coin ay head and tail, samantalang yung rolling a die 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Pag sinabi natin theoretical probability, ano ba yung theory natin dito? Ano ba yung magiging probability in a theory? So, of an event is the number of ways the event can occur or favorable outcomes divided by the number of the total outcomes. Kaya, in tossing a coin once, ang magiging probability of choosing a head is 1. Kasi isang head, then ang total natin ay 2, kaya magiging 1 half. So, ganun din ang magiging choosing a tail. So, magiging equal din kay 1 half. Pero, pag nag-conduct na tayo ng experiment at kukunin na natin experimental probability, hindi tayo makakasiguro that choosing a head is still 1 half o kaya ang choosing a tail natin ay magiging 1 half din. Pero magkakaroon tayo ngayon ng tinatawag nating guide na kung saan ang probability nito in theory o kaya theoretical probability ay magiging 1 half. Pero syempre, kaya nga sinabi natin probability, diba? Chance, diba? So hindi naman ibig sabihin na laging 1 half ang lalabas. Example, nag-toss tayo ng coins at 10 times, diba? Lumabas dito ay 7 yung tail. Okay, ay yung head. Tapos yung ating laman natin dito ay thrice. Ibig sabihin, the probability of getting a head is 7 tenths while the probability of getting a tail is 3 tenths. At least, di ba, malapit ngayon kay 1 half, di ba? So, hindi man siya naging equal kay 1 half, hindi naman naging equal kay 5 over 10, but still, nagkaroon tayo ng guide na at least yung magiging probability of choosing a tail or a head natin ay somehow ay medyo malapit kay 1 half. Pero siyempre, meron pa rin naman chance. Alam mo, possible pa rin niya magiging 9 over 10, di ba? At possible din, gusto mo magiging 10 over 10, pero napakalit naman ng chance na magiging choosing head natin dito ay 10 over 10 or equal to 1. At ang lit din naman ng chance na mangyari ngayon ang 9 over 10. Pero, there is still a chance. Kasi nga, chance nga yun, di ba? Kaya, dito pagdating sa experimental probability, kung ano talaga yung nangyari sa pinaka-experiment natin kapag ka nag-repeat tayo. Pero dito, in theory, or kaya naman, theoretically speaking, sa magiging probability ng choosing a head is 1 half and choosing a tail is also equal to 1 half. Okay, so let us give an example. So Mark is preparing for the upcoming San Pablo City Division Meet Basketball Tournament. But as of this moment, so since we are in the pandemic, lahat ng tournament dito ay pansamantala. Okay, temporarily, ipinagbabawal muna. So, during their practice, he was able to do a 3-point shot 8 times out of 15. So, ilang try dito? 15 tries tayo, di ba? So, since paulit-ulit na kinakandak ngayon itong pag-shoot ng 3-point, so, ibig sabihin, it is an example of okay, experiment probability. Ang tanong natin dito, what is the probability that Mark can be able to do a 3-point shot? Okay? So, kung kukunin natin yan, na i-shoot ngayon ni Mark 8 times successfully, then divided by 15 trials. Kasi, nag-try siya ng 15. So, therefore, the probability of that Mark can be able to do a 3-point shot is equal to 8 over 15. But theoretically speaking, ang probability na papasok ngayon ang 3-point shot is equal to 1/2. Bakit? Possible na pumasok o kaya possible na hindi pumasok, di ba? So 1/2. Kaya makita natin yung guide natin dito ay almost malapit ngayon kay 1/2 yung 8 over 15. Pero sabi nga natin, pagdating ng experimental probability, hindi naman tayo makakasiguro na theoretically speaking, yun ang lalabas, di ba? Sa 1/2. Okay? Okay, so for the second example, in an experiment made by Kyla, the die is rolled 20 times and the number 5 occurs 6 times. So what is the experimental and theoretical probability that 5 shows up on a dime? So unahin muna natin ngayon ang experimental probability. So ilang beses daw lumabas yung 5? Diba sabi natin 6 times. At ilang beses natin kinandak yung pag-roll ng die? 20. So therefore, pag kinuha natin ngayon ang experimental probability magiging 6 times out of 20 trials. Kaya ang magiging probability natin dito of showing a 5 is 6 over 20. Pag nilower term natin, divide by 2 ang 6. Tapos, divide by 2 ang 20. Kaya makukuha natin ang 3 over 10. Okay? But theoretically speaking, ang magiging probability natin dito ay 1 over 6. Dahil, so, ang magiging sample space natin dito, di ba? Magiging 1, 2, 3, okay, 4, 5, and okay, 6. Ito yung magiging sample space natin. Then, ilang 5 ba ang makahanap natin dito? Iisa lang naman yun, di ba? Iisa out of 6. Kaya, the theoretical probability that the number 5 shows up on the die when rolled is 1 over 6 or 1/6. So, since we already differentiate experimental probability from theoretical probability, so let us now proceed with the learning task number 1 is about roll it. Okay? Sabi dito, the table shows that the result of Michael rolling a die 100 times ang dami, then we need to answer the questions that follow. Okay, so for number 1, what is the theoretical probability of a die showing a 3? Siyempre, magiging probability natin dyan is only 1/6. Bakit? Isang 3 out of 6 na possible outcomes. So, theoretically speaking, ang magiging probability ito ay equal kay 1 over 6. Next, number 2. What is the theoretical probability of a die showing an even numbers? Ano ba mga even numbers natin dito? 2, okay, 4, okay, 6. Ilan lahat yon? 3. Tapos ang pinaka-total outcomes natin ay 6. Kaya magiging 3 over 6. Pag ni-lowest term natin, divide by 3 over 3. So magiging equal kay 1/2. Next, punta tayo ngayon kay experimental probability. For number 3, in the experiment done by Michael, what is the probability of a die showing an odd number? So, mga odd numbers natin dito ay 1, 3, and 5. So, ilang beses ba nag-show up yung 1? 16. Yung 3, 22. Yung 5 ay 18. Kaya pag ginuha natin ngayon ang total number of sample space in picking or choosing an odd number, i-add mo lang ngayon na 16 plus 22 plus 18 na magiging sum ay 56. Kaya pag ginuha natin ang experimental probability ng showing an odd number, magiging equal kay 56 out of ang total natin ay 100. Then, i-lowest term natin, pwede itong i-divide by 4, magiging equal kay 14. Then, i-divide by 4, magiging 25. So, the theoretical, the experimental probability of showing an odd number is 14 over 25. Okay, so continue natin sa question number 4. So, based on the frequency of occurrences of the numbers in a die, what is the probability that a die showing greater than 5? Ang greater than 5 lamang natin dyan ay 6, di ba? So, ilan yung frequency natin dito? Okay, ilang best nag-show up yung 6? 14. Kaya magiging probability natin is only 14 out of 100. Then, i-lowest term natin, divide by 2, magiging 7. Divide by 2, magiging 50. So, the probability is 7 over okay, 50. Next, number 5. When Michael rolled a die 100 times, what is the probability of a die showing a 2? So, meron tayo ditong 20 times, kaya magiging probability is 20 over 100. Then, syempre, divisible by 20, magiging 1. Then, at 100 divided by 20, magiging equal kay 5. Kaya, the probability of a die showing a 2 is 1/5. Proceed tayo ngayon kay learning task number 2, make it simple. Okay? So, solve the following word problems involving simple events. For number one, Mrs. Formento, a grade 8 math teacher, prepared a list of Maginhawa Community Pantry. Okay, dito talagang susubukan na ang mga Pilipino ay talagang handang tumulong. So, beneficiaries in selected barangays in San Pablo City sponsored by PDF MNHS. O, nakalimutan ko ano yung PDF na yun. Ibig sabihin yung MNHS ay Memorial National High School. So, Alumni Association. So, there are 50 beneficiaries from San Rafael, tapos 25 in San Nicolas, 10 in Santa Monica, then 30 in Santa Roque, and 45 in Santa Veronica. So, what is the probability that a beneficiary to be chosen is letter A from San Nicolas? Okay, bago natin sagutin yon, ang total outcomes natin dito, i-add mo lang lahat yon, 50 plus 25, plus 10, plus 30, plus 45, magiging total beneficiaries natin dito ay 160. Okay, sagutin natin yung letter A. What is the probability that a beneficiary to be chosen is from San Nicolas? Nasaan yung San Nicolas natin dito? Hanapin natin, we have, okay, 25. So, kaya ang magiging probability natin dito is 25 over 160. Then, divide by 5, magiging 5. 160 divided by 5 is 32. So, ano naman ang probability that the beneficiary to be chosen is from Santa Veronica? So, ilan lahat yun? So, we have 45. Kaya magiging 45 over 160. Then, divided by 5 over 5, so we have 9 over 32. Next, so pag nakakita ka dito ng word na or, ang gagawin mo dito, i-add mo lang yung beneficiaries from San Rafael na magiging 50, then Santa Monica na magiging equal kay 10. Kaya ang magiging probability natin dyan ay 60 over 160. Then, ilawas term natin, divide by 20 and 60, magiging 3. 160 divided by 20, magiging equal kay 8. Kaya ang probability natin dito is 3 over 8. So, let us continue to question number 2. So, Mr. De Las Alas wrote each letters of the word Sampaloc Lake in a card. Okay? If he flips a card, what is the probability that the card chosen is a vowel? And for letter B, letter K. Okay? So, pag binilang natin dito ang number of letters in the two words Sampaloc Lake, meron tayong 12 letters. So, let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, 12. Next, so since a vowel, ang vowels natin dito, A, O, A, and E. So, ilan lahat yun? So, there are 5 vowels out of 12. So, the probability of choosing a vowel is 5 over 12. So, for letter B naman, ano naman din probability of choosing a letter K? So, ilang K meron tayo? So, this 1K, then another K. So, there are 2K. So, we have 2 out of 12. Pag ni lowest term natin is equal kay 1/6. Okay, next, learning test number 3 is about experiment time. So, conduct an experiment in tossing a coin 20 times. Okay, record its occurrence by completing the table below. Then, answer the guide questions at tara. Siyempre, ang magiging total outcome sa atin dito ay 20. So, dito, pwede ka mag-conduct ng sarili mong experiment, diba? Itoss mo ngayon yung any coin. So, pwedeng piso, kaya 5 peso, any coin. Okay? Tapos, i-record mo lang. So, ilang beses ba lalabas yung head, ilang beses lalabas yung tail. Siyempre, ang total natin dito ay 20. Okay, bigyan kita ng example. Bawa, lumabas yung head ay 8 times. At tapos, nag-land ngayon ang tail ay 12 times. Siyempre, magiging total natin dito ay okay, 20. So, pag ginawa natin ang theoretical probability of tossing a head coin, syempre, magiging equal kay 1 half kasi 1 head, then ang total outcomes natin dito ay head and tail sa dalawa, kaya magiging 1 half. Pero pag ginawa natin ngayon, yung sa letter B, after the experiment you have done, what is the experimental probability of tossing a head coin? So, meron tayong 8. 8 out of what? Out of 20. Pag dinivide natin to by 2, by 4, magiging 2. Then, yung 20 divided by 4, magiging equal kay 5. Kaya, magiging 2 fifths. So, hindi man siya ganun ka equal ngayon kay 1, ha? Pero at least, di ba, medyo malapit, di ba? So, may chance pa rin na possible na magiging 1, ha? Pa rin yung probability natin. Next, what is the experimental probability of tossing a tail coin? Siyempre, meron tayong 12 out of 20. Tapos, ilowest term natin, divide by 4, magiging 3. Then ito, 20 divided by 4 magiging equal kay 5. Okay, isa pang technique, so pwede natin yung i-minus kay 1 itong 2 piece na nakuha natin. Kasi in tossing, in getting a head coin, so magiging 2 pips. Kaya 1 minus sa 2 pips, then itong 1 na to, pwede natin gawing 5 over 5. Tapos sa 5 minus 2, magiging 3. Then over 5. Okay, isa pang technique, so pag nag-minus tayo ng 1 over 2 pips, ang pinaka-technique dyan, 5 minus 2, magiging 3. Tapos copy mo lang yung denominator, kaya magiging 3 pips. So ganun yung gagawin, di ba? So kaya for letter D, syempre, ang mathematical concept na gagamitin natin is about experimental probability. And for letter E, what do you think is the importance of conducting an experiment in determining the probability of something may occur? So dito, ang possible sagot ko dito ay, we could determine whether the theoretical probability will occur in the experimental probability. Kasi sabi natin, 1/2 daw yung choosing ahead. So, naging 1/2 nga ba? Hindi naman naging 1/2. So, pero at least, medyo malapit kay 1/2, magiging 2 pips. Kasi sabi nga sa inyo, itong theoretical probability na ito ay magiging guide lamang natin. Pero hindi tayo makakasigurado na yung ba talaga ang lalabas kapag nag-conduct na tayo ng experiment. So, medyo maiksi pa naman yung video natin. Pwede natin ituloy ngayon kay assessment. Okay, choose the letter of the correct answer. So, for items 1 and 2, pero I think hanggang 3 ito, the table shows the results of Mr. William spinning a 1 to 5 wheel of fortune 20 times. So, ilang numbers dito? Bali, 5. Tapos, ilang beses daw dito kinandak? 20 times, ano? Okay, so kunin natin ngayon ang theoretical probability of obtaining a 5. Siyempre, ilang 5 ba? Isa lang naman. Tapos, ang total natin dito ay 5. So, theoretically speaking, pag kinuha natin yung 5, magiging equal lamang yan kay 1/5. Okay? Next, number 2. So, what is the theoretical probability of showing a prime number? Okay? Pag sinabi natin a prime number, ibig sabihin, it has two factors, 1 and itself. Kaya, ang prime numbers natin dyan, 2, 3, and 5. Ibig sabihin, it has two factors, ha? Two factors. So, yung 1, hindi natin pwede i-classify na prime number kasi it has only one factor. Yung 1 lang talaga mismo, di ba? So, kaya, 1 is neither prime nor okay composite. So, ang magiging probability natin dito ay 3 out of, ang total natin dito ay 5 outcomes, kaya 3 pips. Okay? Next, number 3. In the spinning done by Mr. Revillame, what is the experimental probability of getting okay, a 3? So, ito yung 3 natin. Ang frequency natin dito, ilang beses nag-land yung 3? So, 4 na beses, kaya magiging 4 out of 20. Then, lowest term natin, divided by 4, magiging 1. Divided by 4, magiging equal kay 1/5. Okay, so number 4, Eliza Valdez, a pride of Calabarzon, seriously practicing her spiking skills as preparation to regional sports competition 2022. Kasi ngayon 2021 talagang bawal pa yung mga sports competition. So itong pangalan na to ay hypothetical, ha? Pero kung talagang titignan mo kung sino si Eliza Valdez, kung kayo ay mahilig sa volleyball, masasabi ko na si Eliza Valdez ang pinakamagaling na volleyball player sa Pilipinas ngayon. Kaya kung bakit tinawag siyang Pride of Calabarzon, dahil siya ay galing ng San Juan, Patangas. Okay, kunwari si Eliza Valdez ay ano pa lang, high school pa lang, okay? So during their practice, she was able to do a first line spike 13 times out of 19 attempts. So what is the probability that Eliza can be able to do a first line spike? So ilan daw 'yon? Meron tayo dito ng 13, syempre, out of 19. Kaya magiging sagot mo lang dito ay letter C, sa 13 over 19. Okay, so number 5. Efren Bata Reyes received a complete set of billiard balls numbered 1 to 15 in a box. Kung kayo ay mahilig sa billiard, dapat kilala niya si Efren the Magician Bata Reyes. Dahil masabi ko na si Bata Reyes ang pinaka greatest billiard player in the world, di ba? In the history. Kaya maging proud tayo kay Efren Bata Reyes. Okay? To check it, he picked one ball in the box without looking. So what is the chance of getting an odd number billiard ball? Siyempre, ang odd numbers natin dito, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, lahat yan. Sa pagbilang mo, meron tayong 8. Kaya ang total natin ay 15, so we have 8 over 15. Okay, so ayun guys, ganun lang yung pinaka-topic natin sa theoretical and experimental probability. So kung nagustuhan mo yung video natin, kindly like and share sa mga klase mo para kahit pa paano sila ay matutunan din itong pinag-aaralan mo Tapos, syempre, kung hindi ka pa nakapag-subscribe, huwag kakalimutan at pakihit mo yung bell all. At sabi nga sa inyo, kayo yung pinakamalakas sa akin, ano, kaya inuna ko yung tapusin yung sa grade 8. At siguro na naman, pagka kayo na grade 9, ay magkikita-kita pa rin tayo, di ba? At kung gusto mong balikan yung mga videos natin, pwede mo naman panoorin din yung mga videos natin para mas lalo mong manuwaan yung topics natin sa grade 8 para pagdating mo na grade 9 ay ready-ready ka na. So, good luck sa inyo, grade 8, at sana pagdating ng grade 9 ay ganun pa rin yung pagpupursige niya sa inyong pag-aaral. So, thank you and God bless.